The third thing that we look at is cultivating community. I think we know community is one of the most effective conduits of the gospel that we have available to us as churches. But let me tell you something you already know as pastors. I'm kind of teaching to the home crowd team today. Community doesn't just happen on its own. Churches are not friendly and open and inviting by accident. If we leave it to accident, actually our default is to be inclusive. Our default is to be reclusive. Our default is to hang out with the few that we're comfortable with and not invite anybody else in. The work of community is hard work. We've got to break ground, cultivate space, cultivate ideas, cultivate a culture that invites people in. I love how Jesus did ministry. And one of my favorite stories is Jesus walking into Jericho. There's a crowd of people pressing in to see this rabbi from Nazareth. Yet Jesus looks up and he sees a short man named Zacchaeus, who is the chief tax collector of his town, at the top of a sycamore tree. And he says, "Zacchaeus, come down. I'm coming to your house today." Now, sometimes in our church world, we kind of see inclusion in community that looks this way. First, you have to believe like I believe. And once you believe like I believe, profess what I profess, then you have to behave like I behave. We've got to change all of your bad habits, the way you talk, the things that you put into your body, the way that you dress. And once you behave like I behave, then you can belong. How many of you, like me, grew up in a church like that? Believe, behave, belong. Jesus turned that model upside down on its head. Understand that Lazarus didn't have a come to Jesus moment up in that sycamore tree. He got an invitation, and Jesus said, "I'm coming to your house today." Do you know the Greek word there was actually Jesus saying, "I'm coming to your house for room and board." It was Jesus's MO when he would go into a new town to set up his base of ministry, his base of operation in somebody's home. What he did is he moved his church office into the house of maybe the most vile, evil, disrespected man, a chief tax collector in his town, because what he understood was this: if Zacchaeus could first belong, then he was going to come to a place where he believed. And the moment he believed, we see the end of the story. Zacchaeus saying, "I'm ready to sell everything, Jesus, and follow you, because all the wealth of the world is nothing in comparison to what I have found in relationship." My question for you is this: would that life transformation have ever taken place if Jesus didn't invite himself first into Zacchaeus' home? The gospel is best preached through community, and community doesn't happen by accident. Healthy community is cultivated.